All right, my name is Anthony Coombs, and I'm the founder of Interact. And Interact is a geosocial location application which uses ambient location to show you how you're connected to other people and why you'd want to connect with them. Now, since the name is called Interact, I thought we'd have some fun and have a very interactive presentation here. So we're going to need a little bit of your participation. So go ahead and download, if you have an iOS device, iPad, iPhone, iPod Touch, at ph.ly/interact app. And then for tonight's presentation, you want to go ahead and allow push notifications and enable the location. Now, there's tremendous value in connecting people together, as long as you do it correctly. And the way in which you want to do this is you want to make sure that you have the ability to make sure that you do not limit battery life, you allow people to have control over their privacy, and you're also able to mimic real-life human interaction. If done correctly, you have the potential for a very powerful network, a network in which can be leveraged for hyper-local targeted marketing, and also can provide customized white-label software for conferences and event planning space. Now, while Interact serves three main purposes, we're going to talk about the one here tonight which is most relevant, which is professional networking. So let's face it, networking is very difficult. You'll pay hundreds or even thousands of dollars to attend networking events with the sole purpose of trying to network with other people who are there to network with you. And then after standing around for 10 or 15 minutes, either by yourself or with other people that you came with, you realize it's pretty difficult to network. So there are people at that event that you're going to want to meet, but how exactly are you connected? How do you get that warm introduction? You can go home, search through your social networks, and then figure that out that way, or the best you can realize that the best time in which to network with that person is actually right then and there at the event. So we want to try and make this a little bit more efficient. So as I said, I like to have fun with these presentations, so I enlisted the help of my two friends. Go ahead and come on up, Scott and Dan. And instead of just telling you about how networking go wrong, we're going to actually show you exactly how this works. All right? If you guys want to come around here. All right. The problem. The first problem here that we have is the creepy hover. Now, the creepy hover is one in which Scott and Dan are going to be talking to each other, and then I am then going to be the person who's going to be the hoverer. We've all seen this at every single networking event, trying to get an introduction. So, go ahead.
Hey, Dan, great to see you again. You did a great job with the wreck in our last Philly Tech Meetup.
Oh, well, thank you very much. It means a lot to me, Scott. You know, I feel it's an upswell here. It's just my heart is filled with it.
People are talking Instagram valuation. I mean, it's going to be...
That right there is the creepy hover, something we want to make sure that we don't do, but you see all the time. The second one that we want to show you here is the interception. And this is where I'm going to pretend not to be interested in anything they're saying, but of course eavesdropping in on their conversation for a way in which I can then interject myself in. So go ahead.
So you had tickets to the Phillies game last weekend, right?
I did. They actually got a man past second base. It was great.
Oh, that's amazing.
Two runs.
Where were we sitting?
I was actually in the right field section, the third.
Oh, the right field? Oh, I get tickets there all the time, too. I love that. pretty good.
Yeah,
I love going over there as well. So.
Now, that is the interception. And so the question is, how can we solve some of these issues and some of these problems? And then we're going to now demo Interact for you and show you exactly what we built. Okay, now once you've downloaded Interact, the first thing that you're going to see is something asking you to connect to Facebook. And you might ask, well, why do we have to connect to Facebook? And the reason is to authenticate the user. If the end result goal of any of these geosocial applications is to provide you with being able to see a person that you might actually meet in person, then it's very important that the person that you see is a person that is purported to be online. So after you connect to Facebook, we're now going to authenticate using the application. And I'm actually using my friend's iPad, so it's in a language that I'm not really sure. But once you go ahead and authenticate through Facebook, what's going to happen is we're going to pull data, which is simply your connections, your likes, and also your networks. Keeping in mind that we're not pulling any data that we have that you've already not allowed to be public on Facebook. So we're not going anywhere deeper into your profile than you not allowed anyone else to see already. Now, once you hit OK, and this is all going to depend on the connection here. So if you're on Wi-Fi, this will obviously be a little bit faster, a little bit better. If you're on 3G, it'll take a second. You're going to come up with a grid. And this grid is going to have a lot of people's faces and pictures and whatnot. And after a few seconds, it's going to populate with numbers. These numbers are points compatibility that you share with other people, okay? And we try to do this to mimic exactly what anything on an iOS device will look like so you can easily understand what's going on. Now, if I tap on, say, Mike F's profile, we can then see from here that he went to Florida State University. We share 224 things in common. Now, this is obviously someone that I've known since elementary school, so we're going to share a lot of things in common. We both went to the same high school. We're both from Tallahassee, Florida. Shout out to Tallahassee. We like six of the same things. And then from there, we can then see how we're connected to some of these other people with their pictures, which will come up in a second as well. From there, we can then go to the chat, chat with Mike, say hello. But here's some really cool stuff with the application separates it from others. When you go to the profile page, you're going to be able to select exactly why you're using the application at this exact moment. So we're going to say, since you're here tonight, we're going to use this for professional reasons. And as far as the privacy goes, I think it's very important to understand that we consulted with over 36 women asking them, hey, we're going to be building an application for networking purposes. You know, how can we get you involved? It's very important that it was built from as much as we could from a woman's perspective, to where we give as many privacy features to where a woman can feel comfortable in using this. If you deselect anyone here and select just friends of friends, now only people that you share at least one connection with will see where you are. If I deselect all of them, then actually we go to be completely anonymous. We can browse completely anonymous throughout the application. We're going to go back to anyone, so we go back here. Now, probably my favorite part of the application is down here with this slider. This slider is an interactive tool to where you can then see anyone from 25 feet out to 25 miles. And so you are in complete control of the application as to who you're seeing and who gets to see your information. So if we go down into, say, 166 feet, you'll be able to see some of the other people who are here on the application. However, just so you understand, because we're, there you go, because you are, we're on a 3G and sometimes Wi-Fi, we're going to put that out a little bit more so we make sure we can get some more people on there. Again, it all depends on the connection that you have. The green dot is there to then show you exactly that the person's online. And if someone wants to send me a message, you'll be able to see what happens when a message is sent, which is pretty cool. It's going to split the screen into two, and then you're going to be able to see the other people. It's going to separate so we know exactly when you have a chat and then when you're waiting to see someone else. So one of the big questions here is monetization, of course. How is something like this monetized? So we want to go out a little bit further here, and what we're going to see is we're collecting a lot of data, and the data that we're collecting is essentially saying that we have what person likes as well as their location. And so if we go ahead and then, okay, and those right there are going to show that Tariq and Christian has sent me messages, which I appreciate. I'll check them out in a second. If I go to Beth, and Beth is a friend of mine from Florida State, and we can look at her profile, and again, we're gathering data. So we can see then that she likes Interact, which is great, but she also likes Chick-fil-A. So we now know that she likes the brand Chick-fil-A, and we also know her trends as to where she goes through her location, through the GPS, through the phone. So it provides one of the ways, the most hyper-local targeted ways to advertise to someone, based on only on what they like, but also their location at any time. When is the best time in which to actually target someone is when they're within the vicinity to where they can actually use that product. You can consider this, think about it, the Philadelphia 76ers knew that you like their brand, you like their team. Through historical data, they can then see that on a Tuesday evening against certain teams, they may have about 6,000 or 7,000 unsold seats. Well, then they can target you knowing exactly that there's 7,000 empty seats, you like the 76ers, you're within the Delaware Valley, they can send you notifications as well as deals, coupons, whatnot. The competitors in this space, actually the other way in which we can go into monetization is through the white labeling of conferences and networking. There are no applications right now in which if you go to a networking conference or event in which you can actually get who's going to be at that event, along with showing you how you're connected to those people. That's extremely valuable. So we're not just saying downloading an application, showing you exactly who's there, but we're also going to show you how you're connected to them in real time. The competitors in the space, I'm sure a lot of you heard of them, Highlight, Glancy, Circle. Highlight is funded, venture funded out of San Francisco, and they have around 70,000 users. Circle has around 70,000 users as well, and they're venture funded out of San Francisco as well. Glancy actually only has 20,000 users and actually just acquired by Facebook on Friday, which kind of gives credence to understanding how big these things can get. The potential in these applications is really in the hyper-local targeted marketing, and that's really, you know, where we want to go with it. Want to go ahead and have you play with the app, try it out, see what you think. Always interested in feedback and comments. We've made it very intuitive and very simple to where whenever I ask people to try out the app, we ask them to play around with it and tell me how it works. Because if really if there's something you don't understand, that's on us, and there's something we should have done better. So go ahead and play around with it. Let me know what you think, and I'm here for any sort of Q&A. Thank you. Sure. And then if he's not using the application right then and there, he'll receive a push notification. And so you don't have to actually be using the application in order to get and receive a message. As of right now with Interact, the reason why we're not why we'll not drain your battery is simply because we're not actually doing 24/7 tracking on the app. It's stamping your location. It's not tracking you. All right? That, you know, is a thought that may come down the road. But as of right now, it's only simply to stamp your location. The technology isn't there right now in any of these applications that if you don't, if you're going to use 24/7 tracking, it's going to significantly drain the battery on your phone. And so that's why we stayed away from that. Asking, how are we going about getting a location? Or?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Sure. It's through GPS. The developer would be much better to answer the exact technical questions. I can certainly, you know, get that back to you, but it's through GPS, and so when you use the application here, this is your location. If you don't use it until you go home, this is still actually going to be your location. So we are less accurate in that regard, but that was done specifically because of the battery issues, which have been a huge deterrent in these applications. Why not go directly to Facebook instead of going through with Interact? Two things. Number one, the hope would be to customize the application for an event so that whenever the person, really what we'd like to do is to go with a ticketing company to where whenever someone orders a ticket for a certain event, they can get the information directly from us. And it's also used with geosocial. And what's important with that is with Facebook, you're only going to get, there's nothing which is going to connect those people. They would have to be on a separate platform. So this would be one platform which all those people are on. So if you have, say, 200 or 500 people at an event, they would then be, you'd be able to then see what they like, not just about your product, but some of the sponsors that you're using as well. They'll be able to know that. So I would say it's a more curated way, also bring in mobile into it as well. Sure, the compatibility, the question is how are we determining compatibility? And the way that we're doing that is simply taking an aggregate of your friends, your networks, and your likes. However, without question, one of the things in which I would like to do at some point is where you're able to then state specifically what things are more important to you, and also going through and showing that if there are certain things that you like that fewer people like on Facebook, that would mean more than, say, if you had a specific like in Target or Coca-Cola. If you like something in which very few other people like, that might be something that might spur conversation more than something else. Are we planning on using LinkedIn at all for this application? Yeah, it's actually been thought about quite extensively. And originally, it was in the plans to do LinkedIn. And one of the main reasons why we did not do LinkedIn was nothing like this had actually been built up until literally 2 months ago. And within the last 2 months, the whole entire space has blown up like crazy to where no fewer than 12 apps debuted at South by Southwest that do this. But when we started to build this, nothing was being done quite like it. Plus, Facebook has a more extensive social graph. But yes, LinkedIn has been thought about, no question. How do you differentiate yourself from Foursquare and some of the other location applications out there? Well, first of all, with Foursquare, one of the cool things about what Interact does and what these geosocial apps do is there's no check-ins at all. So you're here you're here. You don't have to take out your phone, do anything like that. So it's frictionless. It's a lot simpler. It's a lot easier for you. But I truly believe that the way in which people will use these is when they get a value out of it. And the way in which people can see more than anything else is if there is an impetus and a need to meet another person, which would be at a networking event or at a conference. I love these things. I mean, I would go to a bar, check out, you know, who's there in the bar, see what's going on. If I'm in an airport, I like to see who's around me, stuff like that. But for the majority of people, it's really when they can meet other people that's going to benefit them in some way, shape, or form. That's why I believe that you try and do it through conferences, through networking events. The questions about the advertising and the promotions being sent to you with the idea that this is maybe something that I don't want. I'm a firm believer that if anything is free on the net, if anything is free in the web, your data is what's there. So I have no issue or problem with that. And the question I would ask for some other people is, you don't pay for Google for search. You don't pay YouTube to watch videos, but you still do. You're not going to stop searching. You're not going to look at videos. And so if you can have the most curated form of advertising, I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing if it's specifically towards what you want. Now, as far as, sorry about the little bit roundabout, but as far as getting the advertisements in, I would definitely think there should be an opt-out. But that would be for the person who doesn't want an ad pushed to them every so often. I personally use Pandora. I don't have any issues with the ads, at all. So it's already being done, but it's just being done. We're trying to do this with location involved as well. With the what's the advantage of using us instead of the big event promoters and whatnot? Without question, I think that this app has so much use for ticketing companies, without question, because they're the ones who control, we're saying, hey, we have 500 tickets for said event. This is something that can be an add-on to where they can then use it directly. That's where I can see this mainly going, and that's where I can see the focus with this. And also about the question about LinkedIn, LinkedIn would be mostly for professional conferences, whatnot, but there are many instances in which you go out and you're in a social gathering and you may want to meet other people, and therefore LinkedIn may not be the best way for that. And so Facebook's still very relevant here too. The affiliate tech community can help me out. Two ways mainly. If you like what we're doing and you like geosocial, number one, spread the word, but also if you're involved with, know of, or run any sort of large-scale events and you'd like to try it out, see how it works, see if people get value out of it, that would be number one, the first thing we should do. We're also starting to build out some other stuff on here as well. Always use development help. I think this is something you really do have to be passionate about. And so if you're into geosocial, you're into connecting people together, certainly come talk to me, send me a message on the app, always answering, happy to say hello.